Ming-Chi Kuo was giving us some updated details on the next iPhone SE. It's just not the boxy iPhone 5 looking one. It's just the updated CPU version of the iPhone 8. He's filled us in on some more stuff and sounds like it's actually going to be happening. Let's begin. So I talked about last time that the design, for the most part, of the next-gen iPhone SE, most likely launching in March of 2020, just like the last iPhone SE back in 2016. This is not flagship iPhone territory, okay? If you're thinking to yourself, this isn't exciting, who cares about this iPhone? It's old-fashioned and there's nothing new. Yeah, it's not supposed to be anything really that exciting or new. That's why they're releasing it in March, unlike every other iPhone, which is released in September before the holidays. That's where you see the big upgrades, the new stuff. This is just for market dominance, mostly, making an affordable model for people who maybe haven't upgraded in a long time and those bigger price points are scaring them away. That's the audience the iPhone SE is going to serve. And in my last video, I talked about it. I was a little bit on the fence about whether or not they figured they want to put an A13 chip in this thing because, you know, a lot of the CPU advantages the A13 chip provided are mostly for dual camera stuff that are only available on the latest iPhones, which all have dual and triple cameras. So why put an A13 chip on a single lens smartphone? But Kuo's confirming it, they are doing that. The fastest CPU in a phone will be available at a very affordable price point, which he also gave us in this more recent report, of $399. So just sitting at around $400, which in my opinion is impressive, given the current iPhone 8, which this is going to be replacing, currently starts at $450. And it's 2 years old, so I find it shocking that Apple's just going to be updating the CPU, giving this thing some more RAM at 3 gigs of RAM now, the last iPhone 8 had 2, and simultaneously lower the price point by $50. You know, lowering a $750 phone by $50 is a lot easier to do than lower a $450 phone by $50 because that's a larger percentage of the original price point. But I guess that's the purpose of the next gen iPhone SE. It's just to provide a phone with really, really good performance to a wider demographic of people so that those who don't care about the bezel-less trend or multiple cameras or Face ID and that kind of thing can just have a phone that will work reliably within the iOS ecosystem and probably have a decent battery life. Another interesting report Kuo gave us was that this iPhone is only coming in 3 colors. This is really, really depressing because I know a lot of people out there that said the iPhone 8 Gold was like their favorite gold iPhone ever. They don't like the newer versions of the XS Gold and the iPhone 11 Pro Gold. They just like the gold from the iPhone 8 era. That was the perfect color, and so many people were happy with it, but Kuo saying they're not doing it with the iPhone SE. The 3 colors are space gray, silver, and product red, which I'm not a big fan of the old gold color, mostly because of the white bezels on the front, so I'm actually fine with this. I prefer the red-looking iPhone 8, and I'm glad that they're continuing that instead of the gold option, because if you're trying to make an affordable phone for more people, but you're also trying to give it a luxury feel, it's just contradictory, and if people are buying a more affordable phone, I feel like it makes sense to give it some color, give it some pop. And that red iPhone 8 was very popular. I remember back when Apple launched that, a ton of people actually decided to upgrade then, and I actually see red iPhones pretty commonly. So yeah, I think it's a good move on Apple, and I love the red iPhone 8 mostly because of the black bezels on the front. So even though it's a traditional design, that phone still does look pretty good. Now there are some bad news that came with the latest Kuo report, and this one is kind of to be expected. It's not really that big a surprise, but it is sad. He said that the follow-up iPhone SE, which of course looks identical to an iPhone 8, will not be shipping with 3D Touch. It'll be moving forward with haptic touch, just like all of the 3 last iPhones Apple unveiled. And like I said, that's to be expected. It's like, yeah, you probably don't want to launch all your flagship iPhones without 3D Touch and then make a $400 budget model with it. It would be kind of confusing. So I guess if you don't really care about the higher performance of the A13 chip and you would rather just have 3D Touch on an old-fashioned design, then the iPhone 8 is probably still worth it. I mean, go ahead and buy it now, or wait for the new SE to come out and then buy the iPhone 8 used or refurbished on some other site. It'll probably get a lot cheaper, and then you can happily keep 3D Touch. But if it helps get the price down, maybe that's the thing that allowed them to lower the price down to $400 with a phone with a very powerful CPU like this. From Apple, it's very rare. I know this is missing a lot of things people care about, like portrait mode or Face ID or fast charger included in the box. box, that kind of thing. But the iPhone SE, for a $400 Apple branded brand new phone, I think it is quite impressive that you're buying a $400 package which has stereo speakers, has wireless charging, has water resistance, and is likely going to get like at least 4 to 5, maybe 6 years of software updates after 2020. That's pretty impressive for a phone at that price point, but there are still a few things we don't know that Quo hasn't given us details on. Some things I would like to know are whether or not they're going to do anything special with the cameras. The old 2016 iPhone SE did get camera improvements both on the front and the rear, so is it possible that maybe they'll start putting the XR camera system in this new iPhone SE? So even though it's a single lens camera on the back, will we still get portrait mode? It has the A13 chip, so should it get night mode performance? Maybe they'll leave that as an exclusive, but that would be cool if they added it in. And will they also give it an updated front-facing camera from the iPhone 8, perhaps allowing for it to record 1080 at 60 on the front or 4K at 60 on the front if it had a camera as good as the flagship iPhones? I guess we'll find out, but that's still things we don't know about. We also don't know if they will center the Apple logo on this one. For the thumbnail of this video, I decided to do it just as a Photoshop test and that kind of thing, but I think to stay consistent with the new iPhones, it would probably make sense for them to center it. And the other wild card, which we're not sure about, is what is Apple going to do with the iPhone 8 Plus? Quo has not mentioned that the new SE is coming in multiple sizes, so more than likely they're not going to update the 8 Plus with an A13 chip, which means that it's probably just going to stick around and they won't change it, which is going to be kind of awkward. They'll discontinue the iPhone 8 once this new SE launches. There's no way they're going to keep selling both, but the 8 Plus is just going to be there, kind of awkward, selling at $550, I guess, for people who want 1080p on a budget iPhone and also like telephoto lenses. 8 Plus is good for some people, nothing wrong with that. People who like the larger footprints will have that too, and a decent battery life. I guess it's still a solid phone, it's just gonna sit kind of awkwardly with the rest of the lineup now. My guess is also that the new SE won't have any special camera features. It probably won't have portrait mode or an updated front-facing camera, just because if it did, Quo probably would have talked about it by now. The fact that he knows there's no 3D Touch, and he knows the price point, and he knows the color options, but he somehow wouldn't know if they were updating the cameras or not. Maybe they will. I hope I'm wrong, but probably it's not going to have anything special in the camera department, because this is just meant to dominate markets where there's not as much income for people to spend $700 to $1,000 on phones. And a lot of you may see this upgrade that Apple's doing in March kind of pointless, but keep in mind, if you look at the smartphone sales in the first half of 2019, the iPhone 8, bizarrely, is still up there. People are still buying that thing. It's actually doing pretty well, despite it not having 1080p, not having an OLED display, it being a very basic phone, but a lot of people just want to be in that iOS ecosystem, I guess. Let me know what you guys think of the iPhone SE refresh. That's just a few months away by hitting me up over on Twitter or joining our Discord. This is your Apple Sheep here, and I will see you guys in the next one.